Hey guys, what is up? Josh here with planetchinchilla.com. Thanks for coming back to the channel. Today we are going to be covering how to chinchilla proof a room, what you need to be aware of, and how to do it correctly. All right guys, quick announcement that I am excited to bring to you here real quick today is we are changing our publishing routine. We are moving to Tuesdays, Thursdays, 8 a.m. Central. It used to be Thursdays at 8 a.m. Central, which meant one video a week. But with how often I have her out and how many questions I see people making on planetchinchilla.com in the comments on blog posts, I figured I could start probably bringing you guys some more content. So going forward, we will be doing every Tuesday and Thursday at 8 a.m. Central. So make sure that if you like these kind of videos, if they are helpful to you, you are liking them and subscribing to the channel, and then you will get all of the new content every week. And then the last little announcement I have for you guys is if you're a new chinchilla owner, make sure that you go to planetchinchilla.com, click on the button at the top that says ebook downloads. We do have a new ebook that came out this year that I haven't really been announcing too often, but I do want to make it available to all of you who are new chinchilla owners. It is a complete guide, over 100 pages long, on bringing home a chinchilla and everything that you need to understand after. Completely worth your time to check out. A lot of the times we have a promo going for it. If it's going on, take advantage of it. Otherwise, let's start diving into how to chinchilla proof a room the right way so that your chinchilla is safe during playtime.
All right guys, we are back. Chili's excited to help you guys out here today with some chinchilla proofing. I am in the basement. We've got her out for one of her dust baths for the week. She's playing, she's enjoying some of her oats that she loves so much. And we want to cover this chinchilla proofing because it comes up all of the time on planetchinchilla.com on how to do it correctly and what you need to be aware of. And I thought that there is no better way to cover this topic but to show you a bad example of doing it. So instead of going around a perfectly proofed room and trying to show you what I did to get it there, I'm going to show you how to do it incorrectly in a room like I was just starting and what you need to be aware of.
Chili is like, come on man, can I just come out and play without a video being made? I'm just kidding guys, she's out all the time without a video being made. Don't let her fool you with her cute self here.
Alright guys, I'm going to try and get the best lighting as possible here in this basement. I actually put lights up specifically near her and her playpen just to make sure that that video quality was really good, but the rest of this basement's kind of dark, but we'll work with it. We're going to start with the most basic thing on the planet here when it comes to chinchilla proofing a room, which is electrical outlets need to be non-used. They need to be empty. So you want them to look like this. A bad example of this, and what you don't want them to look like, is something like this. This is why she is not out right now down here, because I had to plug in these lights. And that is danger, danger, danger right there with those cords running out here. You do not want cords. These guys chew everything. And I promise you they will chew those cords. I haven't not seen her chew something if she has a chance. She's trying to chew right now.
Say hi. Say he's right. I'd eat those cords in 2 seconds if I wasn't in this playpen right now.
So, whatever room you're going to use, which I would just recommend if you don't have a good room for it, to go get a playpen. I will put a link in the description below on my favorite playpens and another video on why playpens are so beneficial, but make sure you do the cords first. So let's unplug the lamps, let's get the phone chargers out of there, toss them, whatever you got to do, get it all out of there. We don't want it, no cords at all. Number two is you need to realize that that sweet little chinchilla over there is always thinking about how to escape. Not necessarily because they don't like you, they are just naturally prone to run. They want to jump around and be chinchillas, I don't know. But they want to get out of here. And an example of why that's not very good if you're not using a playpen is that wide open doorway right there. So you may be thinking, well, what if that's chinchilla proof too? That's fine. If that's the case, you're good to go. But in my situation, it's not. It leads to my washer, my dryer, all sorts of dangerous stuff. The furnace, the AC, it just wouldn't be good in any fashion. So you want to make sure that whatever room you're using, that whatever access they have in that room is either access to another proofed area or they don't have access at all. keep that in mind. And they can jump, so you need either a door that closes or some kind of barricade. Whether that's boxes from Menards, whatever the case may be, block it off or shut the door. All right, guys, number three on the list, and this is something I don't know if a lot of people really do, but I think it's beneficial, is I took the legs off of this furniture here and all the furniture in this room for when I do have it proofed and these lights not plugged in. And what that does is it eliminates their ability to go underneath of stuff, which isn't the end of the world if they do. It's just a pain in the butt when they do it, especially when they don't feel like coming out. Usually that's not an issue, but if you want to completely avoid it, just take the legs off of it so it sits flat on the ground. On top of that, push that stuff up against a wall. Then they can't go behind it. When they're out in a playroom, if it's big and interactive, that is awesome. But the more safe things that you can do and the more access you can remove from them, the better and the easier it's gonna be to get them back in the cage, to just interact with them in general. So block off the entries, try and keep stuff flat on the ground and push stuff up against a wall in that room, and it'll just kind of force them to the middle to where they are playing and they don't have a ton of places where they can go that are a nuisance. Guys, the next one on my list is one of the most basic there is when it comes to owning a chinchilla, and that is temperature control. We want to stay in those proper temperature ranges, so that 60 to 70 degrees, low humidity, that's what you're looking for. Obviously this basement is perfect for it. We have dehumidifiers. It's about a cool 65 down here. You want to make sure that whatever room your chinchilla is playing in, wherever they're going to kind of work up a little bit of stress to where they're not going to overheat. And I will put a link in the description below that covers everything you need to know about proper temperatures for these guys. But that is a huge one. Temperature controlled, air conditioner, no access to everything else, no electrical cords, and block off other kinds of entries. The last one on this list, and I will have you guys on your way, is just using some common sense with toxic items. That could be artificial plants, real plants, stuff that may have paint on it or that they could chew and find a way to get some kind of toxic substance off of it. Make sure that stuff's out of there. They shouldn't have access to anything that could hurt them if they chew it or ingest it, and they really shouldn't have access to ingest anything unless it's something you planned on them ingesting, like a treat, oats, whatever the case may be. But any of those miscellaneous items around the room, get them out of there, make it as safe as you can, throw a dust bath in the middle of the room, and you'll be good to go. Guys, as always, Chili and I appreciate you coming by the channel. Again, we are going every Tuesday and Thursday from now on at 8 a.m. Central for new videos. If this has been helpful to you at all, please like the video, give me and Chili a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to check out that ebook on planetchinchilla.com. And Chili and I will see you on the next video. Thank you for stopping by. Take care.